Hello all, welcome back to the Exposing Grief YouTube channel, where we begin to remove that stigma of grief and expose it for what it truly is, which we all know is a natural and healthy way of living and loving. I am so excited you've decided to join me for this month's interview with Christine Lord. She is a licensed clinical counselor and a somatic experiencing therapist or clinician. So she brings a really unique light to grief, and I'm so excited for you guys to hear what she has to say. She is so kind and just an incredible human being. And she talks about finding this sacred wholeness throughout your grief journey. So sit back, enjoy, and just hear what she has to say about sacred wholeness and grief. Take it away, Christine. Hello all, welcome to the Exposing Grief YouTube channel. I'm so excited to welcome our guest this month, Christine Lord. She is an LICSW and a somatic experiencing practitioner. That's right? Did I get that right? Yep. Okay, so I'm excited to welcome her. So welcome, Christine. Thank you so much for joining me for this little interview to learn more about yourself and what you do and what you offer to not only your clients, but possibly to the viewers at home who are going through grief and kind of looking for something either different or in addition to talk therapy. So I'm really going to turn it over to you if you just want to tell us a little bit about yourself and kind of the type of work you do or what got you in to the work that you do.
Yeah, perfect. Well, thank you. Thank you so much for having me. I'm actually really excited to talk with you and share just everything that I can and hope that it's useful. And so for me, I came into this as a social worker, and I just knew that I wanted to help in all the ways that I could, in a lot of communities that were, you know, having a harder time. I found myself working as a case manager in the homeless community, working with severe and persistent mental illness, chronic chemical dependency. I've always just had a deep desire to serve. And what I know about myself is I've been studying a very long time on how to really hold space for suffering and challenging parts of life. And so I decided I wanted to go into clinical social work and become a psychotherapist, found myself in the world of trauma, and realized again, there's a lot to hold in the world of trauma. And eventually I got to a point where I was like, oh, I think I need more. This talking thing isn't like getting me exactly where I need to go. And of course, today we know a lot more about trauma, and we recognize talk therapy isn't always the best way to get at trauma. And so I found somatic experiencing. And that was just amazing because it just opened up this world, right, of understanding our bodies and our nervous systems, right, the patterns, the energy patterns, all the emotions and all the different things. And so I didn't have to chase people's brains anymore, which, you know, sometimes minds can be kind of tricky. And so I realized I could get more in depth. Get more information through this somatic lens. And then after that, there was one more layer that I had to kind of go through professionally, which was about really understanding the spiritual kind of container. You know, I would kind of come to my sessions and still feel like, oh, but why? You know, where's the meaning? Where's the purpose in all of this suffering? And so I found a really strong desire to connect with spiritual teachings and understandings. And that really was kind of the final piece of the puzzle that came together for me professionally, was to just say, yeah, there has to be some greater meaning or understanding. And so now here I am today, bringing all of those things together.
I love that. I appreciate that you mentioned that you as a clinician kind of felt like, okay, this talk therapy isn't really enough. It's not getting me to where I want, you know, even as a clinician with your clients, because I think that will give clients or those who are thinking about doing some sort of therapy, whatever that might be, the permission to say, I need more. Yes. I need more than this talk therapy. Yes, this is great. This can get me to a certain spot. But what's after that if I still feel like there's more? So I appreciate that even you as a clinician can label that. So it gives them permission, not that they need it, but it can give them permission to go, yeah, actually, I think I need something different.
Mm-hmm. Yes. When I think a lot of people do have that experience of, this isn't quite it, or it's not quite satisfying what I needed, but I don't know, right? I don't know. I don't know what else is possible. I don't know what this is supposed to even feel like or be like, right? So to kind of start naming like, yeah, you have options.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. I love that. I love that. So go ahead and talk to us a little bit about the specific method that you guide clients through and or what restoring sacred wholeness means.
So they're beautifully interwoven here. And the way that I kind of think of how I work with my clients is actually more of like a framework. Mm-hmm. It really is a lens. And so restoring sacred wholeness really is about seeing life through the eyes of sacredness. Knowing that everything we experience is sacred, all parts of life are mm-hmm. sacred, that we are sacred, that what we go through, what we feel and experience is sacred. And it's a very different kind of framework because, and this can happen in the therapy world a little bit, where we can kind of hyper-focus on, well, let's get you better. Let's fix this up. Oh, you don't want to feel bad for too long because that's not good, right? And so mm-hmm. then people are like, oh, I have to avoid certain negative emotions, right? And so what I'm really inviting people to do is to see that, yes, even uncomfortable, challenging, hard experiences and emotions actually have purpose and they have meaning.
Love it.
Yeah. Yeah. So from there, that's when I can kind of go in a little bit and we can start breaking down, well, what does wholeness mean in your whole body, right? You have a body, you have a heart with emotions, mm-hmm. you have a brain that's thinking all kinds of stuff, yes. right? And you have a soul, you have some kind of higher guiding self, right? And so in my work, then it really is about bringing all of this forward, getting all kinds of curious, right? Exploring in the most compassionate, right? And kind way, knowing that it's hard to be human, gets messy sometimes, and that's okay. Mm-hmm. And that's okay. That there's a space. So my sessions always feel like that container, right? Where you can kind of
love apart. It.
Yeah.
Yes. Yes. Yeah. And we need that. It's important to have that safe space. I know we talk about this a lot in the therapy world, and I'll talk to clients about it, of certain definition of things. So how are you defining sacred, just for people who mm-hmm. maybe have a different definition or aren't really sure what something being sacred means? How are you defining sacred in terms of this interview and then just how you work with clients? What does that mean to you?
Yeah, absolutely. Sacred to me really feels like just honoring all that life brings to us.
Yeah.
Right. And so thinking about, for me, I use a lot of teachings around nature and kind of Mother Earth, indigenous concepts, you know, that everything is a part of the whole. And so then people can see, right, you're just a little mini Cosmo inside of you that is going to have all, you're going to have your thunder, thunderstorms, right, and your rainbows. You know, you're going to have your volcanoes and your beautiful rainforests. You're going to have all of these things, and not one is more important than the other. And I think that's really what I want to hit home with for a lot of people is like, no, this isn't just about being on inner peace lane until the day you die. Like, yes. That's not what this is about. This is about really learning how to embody like life and all of the things that it brings.
I love that. Yes. Thank you. Thank you for that definition. I think that will resonate with a lot of people. And it's similar to, you know, I talk to clients about honor your grief journey, which is exactly that, of recognize where you're at and go, this is okay. And do the things that fit with where you're at. So that's beautiful. I appreciate that you create that space for people and guide them through that, because that can be hard to do.
Absolutely. Yeah. Thank you.
Great. So how can restoring sacred wholeness help those who are walking through their grief journey in particular?
Yeah, this is really rich territory, just even examining grief. And there's so many aspects to life in general, right? I think, so what I really invite people to do is to connect with their bodies, really listen to sensations, right? Get to know what emotions are here, what kind of thoughts are going on during something in particular. And I think grief is very complex, right? Mm-hmm. Very complex. There could be all different kinds of emotions, right? It's not going to just be sadness, right? You're going to run into anger, right? You're going to run into feeling lonely, right? Yeah. Guilt. Mm-hmm. You might even be shutting off all of the emotions and feeling nothing, right? And so inside your body, feeling those things, it could get kind of uncomfortable, you know? And then you're going to have physical reactions and responses, you know, lots of overwhelm in the nervous system, really activated, feeling like things are out of control, oceans, right? Or kind of checked out.
Don't even
know what I'm feeling right now, right? And everything in between. And so bringing that awareness to what's going on inside of me can be really powerful to start to unpack. And then even thinking about like the stories, right? Mind, the thoughts, the narratives that we might sometimes get stuck on in the middle of the night, right? Mm-hmm. Or holding on to I should've's, right? I could've's.
Right? What if?
That's right.
Yep.
Exactly.
Yeah.
So really being able to kind of pull all those pieces apart in this moment of grief, you realize. Yeah. It's very, very complex.
Oh, that's beautiful. Yeah, I have talked to a lot of clients about their narratives and the emotions that they're avoiding because it's too much. And we talk a lot about exactly what you're saying of it's okay to be comfortable with the uncomfortable, right? Mm-hmm. It's okay to learn how to do that. Yes. So I appreciate that you create that space for clients to really learn what does that look like and how might that help their grief journey.
Absolutely. And you know, when you can better understand and connect and bring consciousness to what's inside of you, that gives you some empowerment to make choices then.
Yes.
What do I need to do with this, right? If I tune in and my body is exhausted because I keep pushing through, right? Or I want to make everything feel as normal as possible, right? You need some rest.
Yes.
Right? I can't hold on anymore. I have to listen to my body and give myself some rest, right? Or there's really so much anger, right? Okay, that anger needs an outlet, right? What do we do with that? How do we channel that? How do we have a conversation with that? Right. Yeah. And so you might need more therapy. You might need to practice journaling. You might need to have rant spaces. You know, you might need to start running. Right. But when we listen, then we can really hear and know, oh, this is what I need to take care of myself.
Yes. I love that. So we know now a little bit more about what your method is and kind of what that looks like. For those who are curious, what sort of things would clients, particularly for grief, be looking out for or start witnessing to go, I wonder if maybe this is the route that I need to go, or I wonder if maybe sacred wholeness is something I want to start exploring. What would they start noticing that would then lead them to you?
I think people who really are noticing, like, I am having a lot of emotions, like it feels almost like too much to hold. If you are really feeling overwhelmed, the kind of work that I would do would really kind of help you find that container and find some safety in your body, you know. And we're not really thinking about safety, you know, when we're kind of going through grief, but the nervous system gets very dysregulated by a lot of emotions. So I would say if you're having a lot of big emotions, also, if you're having somatic kind of components with your grief, if you're having a lot of like stomach aches, or you're feeling really exhausted, or your heart is just constantly aching, right, where you're really feeling it in your body, and you're just like, I don't know what to do with this. Yeah. I don't know what it means. You know, that's a nice place in somatic work is we invite the body, you know, to the table. I want to listen to your body. I want to hear everything it has to say. I want it to have an opportunity to speak and to be heard, right? And it's building trust with your body. It's nourishing, it's loving. I think people who really can sense, I got some stuff I need to get out. Yeah. And it's really, it's not pretty always. Or I've had some people tell me, I feel like I'm complaining in my regular talk therapy and I don't feel like I'm getting anywhere. Right. And so it feels like, geez, I'm not making any headway. And you know, it's a journey. So like, I get it, but if it really, if you're not feeling nourished, then I would say, especially with my concept around wholeness and lots of compassion and how do you nurture and take care of yourself, mind, body, and spirit, you know, you might need a little bit of a different container to say, okay, how do I hold myself in a really loving way and listen to my inner guidance, my intuition, the things that are coming up within me and finding that plan and not just coping skills. Coping skills are beautiful. They're nice. Yep. We all need them. Right?
Yep. Right?
but my work goes deeper, you know, and like, what does your soul need right, to extract from this experience? So transmuting some wisdom.
Yeah. I see the coping skills as kind of the band-aid, right? They're good. They treat the symptom or they at least ease the symptom. And then your work really gets to the root of the issue, which is fantastic.
Yeah.
So for the viewers who are interested, can you talk a little bit about, before we wrap up here, about what they can expect in working with you and then how they can get a hold of you?
Absolutely. So right now I offer telehealth.
Okay.
It's just nice and easy and we can meet wherever and whenever. And the best way to get a hold of me is at christinelord.com, my website. It's really easy. And it's very, I'm very open. I'm very intuitive based. So whatever you kind of need coming in, we'll address that, kind of feel into, do you need longer term kind of work or do you just need some brief work because you got to work through this very particular thing and then you're ready to move on. That I'm very open because I'm always going to be following your unique kind of individual journey. Because another thing I did want to say, which I'm sure you know all about, is no one journey of grief or any particular experience is the same.
Yes. Right?
And so we really want to hold space for what is going to kind of come up, what's going to get stuck, you know, what needs some movement. And also another thing that I just wanted to mention is sometimes when we have a kind of a traumatic experience, something that really kind of shakes us to our core, it can unearth old patterns, old traumas, old, you know, relationship issues. And so you might have some compounded pieces. You know, it's like here I'm dealing with this grief and loss here, but now I'm dealing with old abandonment wounds or, you know, different things. And so, you know, just needing more support. And that could take a little bit longer too. Yeah. So
beautiful. Well, I thank you. I thank you for your time. I will put, viewers, I will put her contact information, in the description below. So if you want to reach out to her, her, email and her, website will be on there. So you can definitely reach out to her if you have any questions. You can reach out to me if you have any questions. Christine, thank you again so much for taking the time and talking about the beautiful work that you offer to our clients. And my hope is that this reaches who it needs to. So I thank you. Thank you for taking the time.
Thank you so much, Brittany. I appreciate it.
Thank you. Thank you all for tuning in. Be sure to subscribe so you don't miss any other content coming your way. And we will be back soon. My goodness, Christine, thank you again so much for your time and for your wisdom around sacred wholeness and how that can benefit one's grief journey. It was such a pleasure interviewing you, and viewers, I hope you enjoyed listening to what she had to share. If you have any questions for her or comments or you want to start working with her, her contact information is below. If you found this interview beneficial or you found any of the other content beneficial on this channel, please don't forget to subscribe to Exposing Grief so you don't miss any of the other content that's coming your way. I'm excited for what March has in store for you all. So hang in there. We're fighting this cold. Take care of yourselves, and I will see you in March.